beyond Dvarim Shebikdusha, Kaddish Kedusha, things that we say in shul that require a minyan, one of the mainstays of tefillah betzibur, of communal prayer, is Kriyat HaTorah. We hear the Torah read aloud. And almost always, we spend that time listening intently to the Dvar Hashem, the word of God that is being read aloud publicly. Of course, the bima, the shulchan, is placed in the center of the room in order to signify Mamad Har Sinai, and we're meant to sit around it. But there's one time of the year on fast days when there's an admixture of the lines where somehow Kriyat HaTorah and Tefillah get almost crossed over one with the other. They're blended as we call out three different times during the Kriyat HaTorah, the Torah reading on fast days. And those are all from Parshat Ki Tisa. Shuv Micharon Apecha, relent Hashem, come back from your wrath or your and your fury. The second time, Hashem Hashem Kel Rachum Mechanu, and the third time, V'salachta Lavoneinu, etc. So all of these are appeals to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and we're in trouble, we're commemorating some type of trial, and therefore we call out Hashem's name as a form of tefillah, even as we're listening to the Dvar Hashem. The Gemara Masechet Rosh Hashanah tells us, Rabbi Yochanan teaches, that if not for the fact that this was written in the Torah, it would be impossible to say such a thing. But he explains that Melamed Shinitatev HaKadosh Baruch Hu Kishliach Tzibur, that Hashem himself wrapped up, as it were, like an emissary of the community, and he showed Moshe an order of tefillah, Beherlo L'Moshe, Seder tefillah, Amarlo, he said to Moshe, Kol Zman Shisachotim, whenever the Jewish people sin, Yas L'Fonik HaSeder HaZeh, they should do this order before me, Vani Mocha Lehem, I will forgive them. Rav Yehuda says further along in this Gemara, Brit Kruta L'Shlosh HaShem Midot, there is a covenant that is forged around these 13 attributes of mercy. She'enen Chazrot Rekam, they never come back empty-handed. And so that's what we're doing. Hashem is the Shliach Tzibur, so to speak. We hear the words read aloud, and we respond in kind. The Pirkei de Eliezer has a bit of a different view and paints for us a different picture of what might have been going on Har Sinai for Moshe Rabbeinu at this moment. It says that when the divine presence, the Shekhinah, passed over Moshe Rabbeinu, Hashem covered Moshe Rabbeinu, as the Torah describes, V'samticha b'nikrat etzruv, V'sakoti kapi, I'll place my hand, as it were, on you. She'avar, when the divine presence passed by, Heisir HaKadosh Baruch Hu et kaf yado me'alav, Hashem, as it were, removed his hand from being upon Moshe, V'ra'a achorei HaShekhinah. Moshe saw the back of the divine presence, whatever that means, but that's the imagery. And at that moment, Hitchil Moshe tzo'ek b'kol gadol. Moshe started screaming with a loud voice. What did he say? Hashem, Hashem, kel rachum v'chanun. Amar lefanav, he said before Hashem, slachna lavonoteihem shal yisrael amase egel. Forgive the Jewish people for the sin of the golden calf. Meaning, according to the Pirkei Eliezer, it's not that Hashem taught Moshe say the following words. It's that Hashem set up the parameters so that Moshe's encounter with the Shekhinah caused him to scream, Hashem, Hashem, kel rachum v'chanun, and that's how Hashem taught Moshe Rabbeinu the Yigyon Mirat HaRachim. What do we do when we hear the Dvar Hashem? We hear the Torah being read aloud as if, so to speak, Hashem is speaking to us as we hear the words from the Sefer Torah come alive and be presented to us. We call out Hashem, Hashem, Kel Rachim B'chanun, and thereby the dialogue of Torah and Tefillah is established more on fast days than in any other day of the year.